Lots of research has been done on the benefits of saving stem cells from a baby's umbilical cord, but not all parents realize that the very same cells can be taken from a child's baby tooth or a wisdom tooth. Health reporter Haley Hernandez explains why some local parents are preserving their children's teeth and the controversy surrounding this.
Well, let's take a look and make sure everything.
A couple weeks ago, 19-year-old Sydney Addix had her wisdom teeth removed and saved in case of an emergency.
You could possibly lose your feet, your hands, your arms.
Addix has type 1 diabetes, an illness that affects pancreatic function. She depends on daily injections and is at risk for a list of health complications.
Maybe someday we can cure your diabetes.
Dr. Donald Cohen believes science is close to reversing her problems through stem cell treatments.
We could provide her with her own cells, so therefore we avoid any rejection type phenomenon, and give her cells that actually will replicate her pancreatic function.
Parents of patients like Sydney now have options to store their kids' baby or wisdom teeth.
Okay, so the way this works is at Dr. Cohen's office, they offer to extract the tooth, putting it in this solution and sending it off for you. Other companies offer to send you the kit and you're responsible for getting it back to them.
These at-home kits, like Store-A-Tooth, say the teeth need to be intact to salvage stem cells, or they recommend taking it to your dentist. Dr. Cohen says he thinks trained professionals are best at handling this process, although right now, laws prohibit patients from getting injections of stem cells within the United States.
You know, are people going to be afraid that we're going to clone people? And that is a fear, and I think it's a realistic fear, and we have to have ethical parameters. We have to make sure that we can police research places.
So all of this shipping, storing, saving stem cells, costing $850 to $2,500 plus an annual storage fee, is only preparing for what could be allowed in the future, when science may be able to use this to grow organs that patients desperately need. Haley Hernandez, KPRC, Channel 2 News.